finding your personal mythology and guiding principles in life by Aion Farvahar. Personal mythology is a declaration of your guiding principles in life, principles that help you live your most authentic life. When you live your personal mythology, everything you do in life feels right, as if you're living the very destiny you were meant to live. Hi, this is Aion Farvahar. I'm glad you're here. This channel is about self-realization and honoring our life purpose and meaning. If you're interested in these topics, please subscribe to stay connected. Your support is the foundation of this channel and encourages me to create more content in the future. Today, we want to focus on the idea of personal mythology. Personal mythology, as defined here, is the collection of everything that helps us make sense of the world around us and navigate life regardless of its circumstances. If you view yourself as a sovereign individual, then your personal mythology is the constitution of your individuality, the guiding principles governing your decisions and your way of life. Do you have guiding principles in life? What part of you brings clarity and gives direction to your life? When making decisions, do you rely more on your rationality, your feelings, or your beliefs? What if what's transpiring around you in the world does not make any rational sense or is emotionally chaotic? What if what you witness in the world challenges your beliefs? What part of you would be guiding you in life, in times when things around you no longer make sense? There are always times in life when our rationality, feelings, or beliefs can no longer help us find our way. That is why we need a personal mythology, a mythology that values any intuitive insight we may receive from deeper transpersonal and spiritual dimension of our being. Having a personal mythology is not just about having a worldview or a belief system, and also includes information received through our dreams, imagination, and intuition. In fact, the use of term myth in personal mythology is meant to highlight this. Back in ancient Greek civilization, myth or mythos were transpersonal stories or motifs that were meant to symbolically represent or guide real human experiences. The idea of personal mythology was introduced by Dr. David Feinstein and Dr. Stanley Krippner in their 1988 book, Personal Mythology: The Psychology of Your Evolving Self. The following quote from this book best reflects the role of personal mythology in life. Through your personal mythology, you interpret the experience of your senses, give order to new information, find inspiration and direction, and orient yourself to the powers in the universe that are beyond your understanding. Without your mythology, your experiences would be disjoint and chaotic. David Feinstein, Stanley Krippner, Personal Mythology. This presentation is meant to highlight the importance of personal mythology and why we all need to find and live by it. More specifically, we cover the following topics. Declaration of personal mythology, an example. How is life without a personal mythology? And how to find your personal mythology? Let's go over these. Declaration of personal mythology, an example. Personal mythology is not an abstract idea, but an idea to live by. So once you know your personal mythology, you need to also declare it internally. To clarify this, let's use an example of such declaration. This is, of course, a hypothetical example, but gives you an idea about various aspects of a personal mythology. If you wish to contemplate on your personal mythology, the last part of this presentation provides some tips to help you with that. Declaration of a personal mythology. Regardless of where my life may take me, I declare my pledge to honor Earth, nature, and all living beings, to celebrate my cultural heritage and gifts, to live life with a sense of gratitude and optimism, to have good intentions and live in harmony with others, to keep my heart open and free from negativity and doubt, to refrain from judging myself and others, to bring hope and positivity to everyone whom I come across, to avoid doing things that awaken guilt and shame in me, to learn to respect, trust, and love myself, and extend these to others who deserve it, to pay attention to my dreams, visions, and intuition, and to live an authentic and honorable life, guided by this declaration. As you can notice in this example, your personal mythology is meant to be an authentic declaration of who you are as a person and the high principles you live by. How is life without a personal mythology? Have you ever wondered what is guiding you in life? It is good to know the answer, because life is filled with challenges, setbacks, and ordeals, and we must learn to navigate all of them, regardless of their nature. For example, if I'm someone who is highly tuned to my emotions and make most of my decisions based on them, how shall I navigate the emotional periods in my life? If I'm someone who sees everything rationally, how am I going to navigate periods in life where things happening around me are no longer rational? Or if I'm someone who has strong beliefs, how shall I navigate my life when things I experience seem to challenge and make me doubt my beliefs? How shall I navigate life when everything I know and believe is not enough to make sense of the world? We need a personal mythology to navigate these periods. Life without personal mythology is like navigating the ocean without a compass, yet expecting not to feel lost. When we live life without a personal mythology, we are not living our destiny. We are just surrendering to the fate that this world creates for us every day. How to find your personal mythology? Your personal mythology represents your authentic individuality and way of life, so it should include everything that is unique and authentic about you. At a high level, your personal mythology should include the following elements. Elements to celebrate aspects of your family legacy, cultural or ancestral traditions, or spiritual beliefs. Elements to honor the practical wisdom you have gained in the course of your life. Elements to support your aspirations and help you evolve to become the person you believe you can be. And elements to help you connect to deeper transpersonal and spiritual aspects of your being, like connecting to your heart, your soul, and your true nature. Let's go over a set of questions that help you establish your personal mythology, reflecting these elements. please keep in mind that journaling is an essential part of this process because it allows you to have an inner dialogue with yourself, ask yourself questions, and find answers. If you notice any mental or emotional blocks preventing you from contemplating on these or finding answers, consider some inner works to understand and remove these blocks. You can also use imagination, meditations, or shamanic journeys to contemplate on these questions. If necessary, consider a vision quest in nature, preferably guided by a shamanic practitioner or an elder. Vision quest is one of the most effective shamanic rituals to find answers to our most difficult questions in life. Here are some questions to ask yourself. You can also improvise and come up with your own questions. What part of your family legacy, cultural or ancestral traditions, and spiritual beliefs resonates deeply with you and is something you want to continue to honor in your life? Based on your life experiences so far, what are the most valuable pieces of wisdom you gained about yourself? Reflect on challenges you have overcome so far in life and see what part of you helped you turn things around. Give this part of you the credit it deserves and commit to stay connected with it going forward. What are the most positive human values that you can find in you? Think about qualities and values that you hold as code of honor and would never consider violating in your life, regardless of what you may have to sacrifice. If you feel you're still evolving and improving in life, who is the person that you're evolving to? How is this person like? Can you imagine it? What personal qualities you see in this person as someone you're becoming? Make a note of these qualities and commit to cultivate them in you. Would you be open to listen to your heart and pay attention to things you seem to know intuitively? Would you be open to contemplate on your dreams or visions and see what they could mean to you? This openness allows you to receive insights and direction from transpersonal and spiritual dimension of your being. For example, from your soul or an inner guide wanting to guide you in life and keep you aligned with your soul contract or your life mission. Would you be open to enrich your life through personal rituals that are meaningful to you and remind you to stay true to your authentic way of life? You can do this by living a symbolic life and by creating an altar that represents that symbolic life. To learn more about symbolic life, check out part 3 of my Soul Sovereignty presentation linked in the description below. Consider contemplating on these questions or similar questions that can help you establish your guiding principles in life. Remember that the best answers to your questions are always within you and cannot be found in the outside world. So if you stay connected to yourself, trust yourself, and listen to your inner wisdom, everything about your life becomes clearer. Closing remarks. In closing, I hope you have found the ideas presented here useful. The most important takeaway here is for you to understand the importance of having a personal mythology in life. Your personal mythology gives you the clarity to live your life in an authentic, creative, and empowering way. Your personal mythology is the wisdom that grows with you to guide you through your life, wherever that may take you. If you have found this presentation inspiring, please like and share it with your like-minded friends. Please subscribe to my channel and share your thoughts and comments. For more information about myself and my life mentorship practice, please find my bio link in the description below. Blessings.